Hello guys, this is Benji Palaron Jr., your trusted licensed real estate broker and entrepreneur and online marketer. Welcome to our new video, and this regarding about ano yung pagkaiba ng isang real estate broker at isang real estate salesperson. So guys, malaki yung pagkaiba ng dalawang ito at i-explain ko sa inyo ano yung difference ng dalawang ito. Before ko explain tong topic natin for today, please subscribe to my channel. Press the bell button para magkaroon kayo ng updates sa aking mga video and follow me to my Instagram para mag-grow naman ito. So tara na, alamin natin ang pagkaiba ng dalawang profession na ito. Okay, gusto malaman ninyo yung pagkakaiba ng dalawang profession na ito, itong pagiging isang salesperson at pagiging real estate broker. So, dapat alamin natin talaga ano ba yung mga professions ng isang real estate industry. So, pumunta tayo sa batas ng CRESA Law ng 9646 para ma-explain natin yung mga profession inside in a real estate industry. So, ito yung mga profession na ito. Una, ang being real estate consultant. Okay, ang real estate sales consultant ay is a duly registered licensed natural person who for professional fee, compensation, or other valuable consideration offer or renders professional advice and judgment on acquisition, enhanced preservation, utilization, or disposition of lands or improvements thereon, and the conception of planning and management and development of real estate projects. Okay, narinig niyo yung real estate consultant. Ito yung mga consultant na talaga in the level of corporate. Pwede kayong pumasok sa corporate. But, guys, being a consultant have requirements. So, ano ba yung mga requirements na ito? Una is you have a 10-year practicing, nagpa-practicing ng 10 years sa real estate industry. And you pass the board exam for real estate broker or nakapag-pass naman kayo ng appraiser and have 5 years experience sa real estate industry. So, pinapractice nyo yung pagiging real estate broker nyo o pagiging real estate appraiser nyo. So, may nakita kayo ditong appraiser. Ito yung susunod natin tatrakay about appraiser. So, ang maganda lang being consultant, talagang napag-aral mo na and you've got experience ka na. And you can talk to developers or the developers will get your services to consult to their projects. Diba? And mostly, ginagawa ng malalaking company yan. Next, ang real estate appraiser. So, ang real estate appraiser ay isang duly registered licensed natural person who for a professional fee, compensation on other valuable consideration performs renders or offers to perform services in estimating, arriving at an opinion of acts as expert on real estate values such as services which shall be finally rendered by preparation of report in acceptable written form. Ito yung mga, ang trabaho ng real estate appraiser is to appraise properties. Ano yung pag-appraise? Ang pag-appraise is to get the fair market value of a certain property. Lalo na yung mga pre-sales. Yan. Or gustong malaman ng client mo, ba, ang client mo bibili ng isang investment sa Laguna, bawa. Eh na may nakita siyang client or meron siyang kitang lupa doon or project na gusto niyong bilhin para doon sa bahay niya o bawa sa business niya. So, before siya magbibili o mag-acquire ng property, kailangan malaman niya yung fair market value. Bakit kaya? Bakit gusto niya malaman yung fair market value? Kasi yun ang trabaho ng appraiser para malaman at bigyan ng datos yung client niya. How much yung fair market value of a certain property. To, ito'y kung malaman niya yung fair market value, maaari niyang bilhin to or feasible to sa kanyang future investment. So, ano ba ang requirement ng isang real estate appraiser? Ang real estate appraiser ay graduate of any course passed in the real estate appraiser board exam. But for now, yun yung alam ko na alam ko like, kasi binabasa ko rin yung updates about sa PRC. Basta you are graduate of any course passed in the real estate appraiser board exam and you will review on the certification of real estate appraiser. I'm very sorry, I didn't indicate to my PowerPoint ano yung kailangan kunin. Kasi kuha ka pa rin ng certification for review na appraiser. And kailangan under accredited to ng PRC. So, magbo-board exam ka, dapat ipasa mo to. Plus, you need a practicing. You have to practice appraiser in a couple of years bago ka malaman mo yung pag-appraise ng property. So, you have to learn the rules, sabi nga, in the fields. And next is real estate broker, licensed real estate broker. Kagaya ko, I'm a licensed real estate broker. Ano ba ito? Ang isang licensed real estate broker ay registered and licensed natural person who for a professional fee, commission, or other valuable consideration acts as an agent of a party in a real estate transaction to offer, advertise, solicit, list, promote, mediate, negotiate, or effect the meeting of the minds on the sales, purchase, exchange, mortgage, and lease, or joint venture, other similar transaction on real estate at any interest therein. Dami, no? Actually, ang isang licensed real estate broker ay isang function niya is to advertise, which is we advertise property, promote other properties, and find clients for a certain property. Yun yung nagawa natin. So, ang maganda ng real estate broker, you are to have the right to sell properties. And properties na sinasabi natin ay hindi naman hindi siya maliitang halaga. It's worth a million, guys, ang pagbebenta ng real estate, ng real estate property. So, it's kind of a challenge para magbenta ka ng ganun. But, if you are willing enough to study the course, maganda siya. And secondly, you will learn about the laws. And, syempre, you help people to have their own home. Yan ang gusto ko pinya real estate broker. So, ano ba ang kanyang requirement? Remember, always we have a requirement for each profession. Nung requirement natin sa 2012 IRR, so ang IRR, implementing rules and regulations sa PRC, ay any graduate course and pass the real estate broker board exam. That was 2012. Any course pwede. Ngayon, hindi na po. Dahil kasi sa IR ng 2016, dapat graduate ka ng Real Estate Management, BS, Bachelor of Science, Science of Real Estate Management. And you have to pass the Real Estate Board exams. Yun yung requirement ng isang real estate broker. Okay? So, naging course na siya 2016. Swerte yung nakakuha ng 2012 ng license. And guys, but the least, ito yung real estate salesperson. So, ang real estate salesperson ay accredited natural person who performs the service for behalf of a real estate broker who is registered and licensed by professional regulatory board of real estate service for or in expectation of share in the commission, professional fee, compensation, and other valuable consideration. So, ang being salesperson ay service on behalf of the real estate broker. Kaya andito, requirement talaga being a salesperson is you must have accreditation under a real estate broker. And I have meron kang 12 years training accredited under PRC. And must have completed this 2 years or 72 years of college education. Ang maganda dito as being a salesperson, you will learn the rules of real estate talaga. You know learn about being a salesperson or to sell a property. And it's fun para bumika at you are a seller. Mahirap maging seller, sabi nga nila. But if you really want to earn more on a certain base or gusto talaga kumita talaga, pwede ka dito mag-sales ka. And we have trainings on how to be a proper real estate salesperson, and we'll help you to develop those skills. So tutulungan namin kayong maging isang karap na salesperson. And ang maganda dito ngayon, since we are in need of salesperson, we are open always to have a salesperson. And guys, ang isang real estate broker ay pwede maghawak ng 20 salesperson. Sa batas yun ng RESA law. So ako, I'm open with other teammates for this. And if you're willing to, or gusto nyo talaga maging salesperson, under my wing, and I will train you regarding about online marketing and real estate. And you want to have better opportunities, guys, I have a link below in my description. Write lang kayo sa Google form and we will contact you, and we have a Zoom meeting para i-introduce kayo in about real estate. Diba? Ganda. So, iyan ang mga different professions in real estate. At yung pagkibilang isang real estate broker at real estate salesperson, guys. And remember, guys, being in sales are very, very advantageous sa inyo. Dahil kasi if you want to be a businessman, gusto mong magnegosyo, dapat marunong kayo magbenta. And guys, I hope may natutunan kayo dito sa video na ito. Please like and share, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell button, guys, para magkaroon kayo ng update sa aking mga video. And guys, if you have comments or suggestions regarding about this video, please comment below and we will answer it to the best I could. And if you have suggestions with other topics about real estate, business, or finances, just comment below and we can work on it. So guys, have a great day and see you to the next.
Thank you so much for watching. See you again on my next video.